Are you looking to smash your opponents at the next standard event, poison your foes in Pauper, or empty libraries in Eternal formats? No matter what way you prefer to vanquish the foul, you'll find the tools you need at channelfireball.com. We've got great prices on singles, boosters, sealed boxes, sleeves, and anything else you need to take home the win at your next PTQ or at your kitchen table. Don't get lost in a labyrinth of online shopping. Just try channelfireball.com.
Welcome to another standard video here on channelfireball.com. I've got a nice Abzan control list all ready to go here. This is the deck list that did well at a Grand Prix Memphis. There's five copies in the top eight, and this is a couple cards off from that. It's got a bunch of removal spells, you know, four Thoughtseize, three Bile Blight, four Heroes Downfall, one End Hostilities, one Utter End, a bunch of Card Draw, Read the Bones, and Abzan Charm. Of course, Abzan Charm's also a removal spell. Then the only creatures are the four Coursers, four Siege Rhinos, and two Tassigur, the Golden Fangs, with five Planeswalkers, Elspeths, a Sorin, and an Ugin. And then the sideboard, so basically the main deck, all you're trying to do is kill their stuff, play Rhinos, Crucifix, or Courser of Crucifix, and Planeswalkers. You just have a lot of ways to two-for-one them off your draw twos, off your Coursers. Tassigur gets you card advantage, Planeswalkers are intrinsically card advantage. The sideboard has four Fleece Mains, because that was the plan. I think the plan's a little less good now that it's a little more popularized, but still want to kind of see how that plays. Because, you know, even if they know you have Fleece Mane, you just don't have to board them in. And if your opponent's leaving in Lightning Strikes that are otherwise dead, you know, that's a win for you. Back to Nature, because it's a card I like a lot right now against the red-white kind of decks that are playing both Chain to the Rocks and Outpost Siege. And then the Royal Sampler of Planeswalkers, Liliana, Sorin, and Nissa against other control decks. And Sorin, of course, can come in with a Fleece Mane even against midrange and aggro decks. And then Drown in Sorrows against aggro, Read the Bones, and Mastery of the Unseen against control. And then End Hostilities for like Green Devotion type decks and Glare to kill Elspeths and Siege Rhinos. So, an 8-player event. Let's see how it goes. All right, my opponent kept 7 cards. I am on the draw. I'm going to keep this hand. It is lacking in green mana sources, but on the draw with a Temple of Silence means I've got confidence I'll hit some. Actually, I'm going to run the turn one Thoughtseize here. If I'm playing as Green Devotion, I only have 1-2 drop here. This could be good. Well, they have lots of 2 drops. They have Caryatid Satyr, so I'm not taking that. The question is, do you take Courser or Genesis Hydra? Courser's easier to deal with, as in I can just kill it, but I think I'm going to... And Genesis Hydra isn't, but I think I'm still just supposed to take Courser here, because without the Courser, my opponent's on 5 mana sources total, which is not a ton. So I think it is worth doing that. But it may not have wanted to sack that land. I have an Urborg in play. It was not mandatory. And Temple of Malady. See, there we go. Hitting a green source already. Lanar Wastes. Yeah, I'm going to put that on top because that way I get to cast Courser of Crucifix on turn 3, followed by turn 4 Siege Rhino. And this is why I took Courser. Genocide is really not going to be online for at least a couple more turns, especially if my opponent didn't draw a land here. So I think I've bought myself enough time. And I don't even necessarily have to play Siege Rhino next turn. Obviously, now after I draw the Windswept Heath and see my top card, I have some control, and I could Read the Bones looking for another Thoughtseize to get that Genesis Hydra out of there. Unless my opponent's playing it for 3 here, which I'm more than fine with. But Whisperwood Elemental, that's a good one. Alright, so my top card is a Courser. I think I want to shuffle away the Courser, so I'm going to play Windswept Heath and get a Plains here. Top card now, an Abzan Charm. I like that more. And then play Siege Rhino, so that way I don't get attacked next turn, giving me time to build up to this Ugin. My opponent's hand right now is Voyaging Satyr, Genesis Hydra, and Unknown. And if they don't draw land, hopefully not a Nykthos. Nykthos would be ugly. Then playing a Hydra is not as impressive. All right, it feels like a Pelucranus or something. I'm just going to take the damage. So, all right, looks like my opponent's setting up for a Genesis Hydra next turn here with lots of Voyaging Satyrs. All right, I would like to find a Thoughtseize if I can. Tassigur the Golden Fang. I can Read the Bones and play Tassigur, I think. No, I guess I actually can't. I will be a card short unless I find a fetch land. So, I think I'm going to exile Whisperwood Elemental. I'll deal with Genesis Hydra later, but at least Ugin can get rid of Genesis Hydra. I guess I'm not technically exiling Whisperwood Elemental. And I think that killing the Whisperwood is what I want to do now. Yeah, I can't really stop my opponent from playing a... I mean, the only way to stop my opponent from playing a Genesis Hydra for 5 or 6 is to read the bones and try to find Thoughtseize. The question now is, do I play Temple of Silence and get rid of this Tasigur? Do I just play Caves of Koilos, keep the Tasigur? Or do I just play Temple and keep the Tasigur also? I think I like keeping Tasigur. But I... what am I going to do next turn? I guess next turn, do I care about having 6 mana? I'm going to draw Tasigur. Yeah, I'm not going to waste the Scry. I'm just going to play this and pass the turn. If I get attacked with that Manifest token, I might double block it this turn. Because if it is a Pelucranus and my opponent flips it, then I still get to kill it, and that way they can't cast Genesis Hydra. What could it be? Arbor Colossus is fine, you know. And if it's a Pelucranus, eventually I'm going to have to deal with it anyway, so... I mean, if it's a Whisperwood Elemental, it's not a big deal. Like, what really gets me here? And if it's a Pelucranus and I'm wasting my opponent's turn plus their mana, then I'm happy enough with that. Looks like my Courser is going to die. Could be an Ashcloud Phoenix, I guess, if they're playing that heavy red, but that seems less likely. Alright. This is a one-for-one that costs my opponent some time, gives me another turn to find a Thoughtseize to get rid of that Genesis Hydra. So, this works for me. Alright, so draw Tasigur, but definitely casting Read the Bones here. Oh, land. I mean, I want to play Ugin at some point, but, you know, I think I'm just going to put both the lands on the bottom. Okay, well, that's not bad. Might keep lands now, yeah. And I'm not going to play Tasigur, even though my opponent knows about it, because of Ugin and Elspeth. I think there's a decent chance that my opponent's going to play now a Hydra for 7, and I have to go Elspeth minus... At least they don't have a Nykthos. Nykthos would be ugly here. But. So, what are they? I hope they don't hit Hornet Queen. And I don't mind too much if they hit, like, a Pelucranus or something along those lines. Let's see what Hydra digs up, shall we? X equals 7. Whisperwood Elemental. Alright. So, I'm likely gonna Elspeth. Well, it's kind of annoying to minus it and kill my own Siege Rhino. Let's see what my land has to say. Bile Blight. No, I don't want Bile Blight. Alright, let's play Elspeth. The question is, do I want to plus it or minus it? Actually, given that they don't have Trample, I'm just going to plus it. And then hopefully set up something good next turn? I don't know. Whisperwood Elemental's tough, because now... Well, actually, Ugin exiles. So now, next turn, I can minus Elspeth, killing Genesis Hydra, Whisperwood Elemental, and then minus Ugin. I guess it doesn't kill all the manifests, which is annoying, but... Or I can just keep plussing Elspeth, and I can just start plussing Ugin on the manifest tokens. That might not be that bad, either. Or I can... I can actually Ugin to minus for like 5. Doesn't kill Elspeth. Yeah, that's kind of interesting. All right, block this one. Block. Double block. Because I'm assuming... I don't necessarily know if I'm casting Ugin next turn, but there's a good chance that my tokens end up dying. Oh, so that was great. My opponent traded 2 manifest tokens for my Elspeth tokens. Okay, I like that. This is another Genesis Hydra that's mildly annoying. But I've got Elspeth, and if I draw land and I have Ugin, then that's a thing too. Yep, this is a Hydra for 8. I guess it could be a Crater's Claws. Nope, it is a Hydra for 8, hitting... Well, Xenagos or a Courser. That's not bad. But yeah, I can Ugin minus 5, killing Whisperwood Elemental, Genesis Hydra, all my opponent's creatures. It exiles, so Whisperwood Elemental's text of sacrifice to when a creature dies this turn is doesn't do anything. I lose my Siege Random, but then I get to plus Elspeth afterwards. All right, so if I draw an untapped land, I think I'm in incredibly good shape here. And even if I don't, I don't think I'm in horrendous shape. Plus Elspeth. Play Siege Rhino? Well, I mean, I could have minused Elspeth, but just keep doing this. I have another Elspeth if I need it. So I have five blockers, my opponent has 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8 attackers. 3 get through, but those 3 can only deal 4 damage total if I let the 2 Voyaging Satyrs through. Like, the Whisperwood Elemental can't attack into Siege Rhino. I mean, even without the Ugin, I'm actually not doing that bad here. This is kind of interesting. Alternately, I could have minus the Elspeth, killing my Siege Rhino, Whisperwood, 2 Genesis Hydras, then played a Siege Rhino, but then I wouldn't have had the 3 tokens, and Elspeth would be at 2. And I have Siege Rhino with Elspeth at 2 against... I think this is better, assuming I get to play Ugin in the next turn or two. Because even though my opponent's making a Manifest every turn, I'm making 3 soldiers, and there aren't that many things that my opponent could have that will get around all those soldiers, especially since the Siege Rhinos are making it costly for all the non-Genesis Hydra cards to attack. Opponent needs an Ilea. I would lose to an Ilea pretty quickly. But if they don't have one, this is looking pretty good. Alright, looks like a 2-2 is coming into play. And let's see what happens. No brawling, making a manifest token. Untap. Abzan Charm. It's not bad. I could just exile the Whisperwood Elemental. Is that better than drawing 2 cards? Probably not, especially since drawing 2 cards hits me both lands and removal spells. And let's see if I can hit. See, there we go. Bioblight's interesting. I'm going to Thought Seize because I'm not really going to have an opportunity to do it later. I don't think my opponent has anything. Oh. Yeah, they probably don't have anything. Oh, Crater's Claws for 20, which is their plan next turn with Plussings and Echoes. I'm not going to say that wasn't lucky. Yeah, let's just pass the turn. I don't really need to play Tasigur here. Elspeth is threatening to go ultimate next turn and win me the game, so my opponent's the one who has to attack, and I can Bioblade the Satyr tokens and put my opponent in a really tough spot here. How much was that Crater's Claws for? 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22. Oh, plus Nykthos, so 50. Well, if one of the manifests is a Pelucranos, then I could be in trouble here. Because my opponent now has millions. But I think if it was, they would have done something last turn. So I assume Elspeth's getting attacked by everything. And let's go ahead and Bioblight the Satyrs here. Let's see if that works. If it does, I mean, I guess there's nothing my opponent could really manifest into that would change that. And if they have Pelucranos, then so be it. All right. Block, block, block. Block. What could you flip that matters? Again, discounting Pelucranos, yeah. All right, well, we won that game without playing Ugins, which I was not expecting particularly. Don't really like Sorin, don't like Fleece Manes in this plan. Read the Bones, End Hostilities, Liliana, Potentials. I definitely like Thought Seizes. Bioblade, I think, is fine. It just kills the Mana Elves. I mean, everything's good here, so maybe I don't want all the Bioblades, it's possible. Probably can't afford 3 Read the Bones on the draw. I don't need to do that. I like End Hostilities. Kind of like Liliana, but I guess against a fast Xenagos, it just doesn't play to the board. All right, I'm just going to put in an End Hostilities then for a Sorin, and we'll call it a day. Oh, yeah, this is a very acceptable hand, if not a super exciting one. Hands like this are where you kind of miss Sylvan Caryatid, but I do think given the climate of Standard right now, it's not unreasonable to play zero. Right, here's where I want Thoughtseize or Bioblight. Those are the cards I'm looking for. Not Sandstep Citadel as much. I've got my four mana. I can just push all lands to the bottom. Hopefully I do not get a... Looks like I'm not getting Xenaghost too early, though. Maybe next turn. All right. Plains, nope. Don't want you either. Even with the Ugin in hand, I think the fact that I've Read the Bones and potentially Abzan Charm to draw extra cards means I really just don't want that. All right, here goes Pelucranus. Hopefully. I say hopefully because I can Abzan Charm it. Tasigur's not horrendous. All right, let's get that Plains back. Let's exile Pelucranus now. Just, I don't think a reason to wait there. Here's Xenagos. Well, Siege Rend is good against Xenagos. Much happier that it happens this turn as opposed to last turn. Well, there's Hero's Downfall, but I think if I just play Siege Rhino, think I'm in better shape because it threatens Xenagos regardless. And I guess my opponent could play a Wisp-Roared Elemental here. Didn't play a land last turn, so that's worth noting. And that now they have. Well, maybe it was wrong to not kill Xenagos there because my opponent gets to plus it to add 2 mana if necessary, so that puts them now to 8 mana and play like a Hydra for 5. Yeah. Now, of course, I do want to draw a land, but I still think it was reasonable to start where I did. Alright. What are we casting? Looks like potentially that Hydra. So yeah, I should have just killed Xenagos, I think. Yeah, it looks like a Hydra for 5. What are we hitting? What are we hitting? We are hitting Pelucranus. I might be in a spot where now need to cast Read the Bones. But next turn my opponent can Nykthos for 5, 6. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Play lands 13. Well, even with 12, it can fight and kill Siege Rhino and deal lethal. What if just Hero's Downfall Pelucranus? Yeah, that was bad. Alright, I think I just Hero's Downfall it now. Because if I just pass, my opponent just passes, and then that's very bad for me. So, had I Hero's Downfall Xenagos, then my opponent would have been on 5 mana. Maybe played like a Wisp-Roared Elemental, or who knows? I would not have a Siege Rhino in play. Then I'd play Siege Rhino. Not in like wonderful shape there, but I think better than the shape I'm in now, which is reasonably far behind. Attack with both. All right. It's a kind of free block there. Interesting. And then but you're gonna plan on plussing Xenagos because you didn't make a token to attack with. But if you're plussing it now, then you have one less creature. I guess I don't get it. 4, 5, 6, 7. Could just be a Hornet Queen. No, could be an Ugin, the Spirit's Dragon. Aha, plussing on the Rhino. Now it all makes sense. I assume I'm like super dead here, but we must fight on. Siege Rhino, Sandstep Citadel. I guess hoping to like Hero's Downfall next turn or something. Opponent's got 3 cards in hand. It's not doing a lot. On the play, maybe I want Liliana here. I could certainly see that. I was pretty far behind here. That would not certainly not have been good this game. Nissa, all right, yeah, we're very done here. All right, let's see. Do I want Liliana on the play? And is Bioblight better than Drown in Sorrow? I think it is, because even though Drown can kill multiple things, actually on the play maybe I just take out the 3 Bioblights for 2 Drown in Sorrows and a Liliana. Yeah, I like that on the play because that way my opponent plays their 2 drop, and then on turn 3 I have it. I can't kill the turn 2 elf, but other than that I'm pretty good. All right, or rather turn 1 elf on the play. Yeah, I think I keep this. It's in need of a third land, but if it hits the third land, it's got a lot of the cards it wants. It's got Read the Bones and Utter End and Courser, so. Come on, Temple. Well, once Upkeep works, I'm just going to play this. I don't think... I actually don't mind drawing a land, so I don't really want to thin my mana out. Hopefully my opponent doesn't have a Elvish Mystic here. Alright. I like the way this looks. Let's get Forest and play a Courser. Drawing a nice white Borderland Ore Wastes. Ooh, no plays, huh? Alright, let's play Temple of Silence. Gain a life. Do I want another Temple of Silence on top? Not really. Let's attack. And now I'm just going to keep mana up. If my opponent plays a Pelucranus, I can just Abzan Charm at end of turn. Otherwise, I can just draw cards. And now I'm pretty firmly in control. My opponent's locked into playing like one spell per turn, and I can just kill one creature per turn. Okay. Let's draw two cards and lose two life, shall we? Draw. My opponent sees the end hostilities. Land. Gain a life. Time to start punishing my opponent with Liliana. Opponent's got seven cards in hand, and I'm not going to attack here because of Xenagos, and because I'm not really winning by damage. But I haven't missed a land drop yet. Ooh, Outpost Siege. Snap discarded Outpost Siege. Interesting. So it probably has another one then. No, I'd just rather play a Pelucranus. Okay. I mean, I guess I like that. Let's cast Read the Bones. If I miss on Read the Bones completely, then I can Liliana for land. Liliana Courser plan. Let's see. Sure, I'll keep Hero's Downfall. I think Hero's Downfall is fine. I'll put these both on top. Unfortunately, I don't want to get value off of the Temple, or off the Courser here. Since I have to discard anyway. Play a land, gain a life, and... Exile Pelucranus. And still no attack. I could ultimate Liliana this game. Yeah, my opponent was like super dead here. I guess they kept a hand that went land go, land go, land go, turn four elf, which was not a particularly wonderful hand, but hey, who knows? It was maybe an elf away from being the nuts, and they did not get there.